sum shows that there is a pretty strong maintenance of inequality overall, right? There is very little upward mobility, and people like to think about college as a place where people, regardless of their economic background, can really move themselves up the economic ladder. Only 1/4 of women from the lower middle and middle class backgrounds were on the path to mobility, which was a bit depressing. Right. When I teach this to my students, they're always like, Professor Hamilton, you're so depressing. This is what I get all the time. But it was the reality of what happened. There was lots of reproduction of privilege, so almost all, or not entirely all, but 2/3 of upper middle and upper class women managed to reproduce into the upper middle class, or were looking like it, right? Many of them are not going to be successful as their parents, but they were making it into the upper middle class. A third of upper middle and upper class women were looking like they were downwardly mobile. So the party pathway wasn't just potentially detrimental to people who were less affluent. Some students were not able to pull it off. Their parents didn't have enough connections or resources after college to compensate for what they had done while they were there. So this leads to sort of two conclusions. So one conclusion and one question that I continue to ask, and I don't entirely know the answer to, but I'm working on it, is college really the great equalizer? And particularly when you take into account the huge amount of students that don't graduate, when I think about that, I often say to myself, probably not. Even when you look among students who do graduate at the same school at Midwest U, it looked like not everybody was getting the same thing out of their college degree. It seemed that it was really important to have formal resources, social connections that they could call someone to get you a job, money to get you to where the jobs were, and put you up until you could get them, right? And that was a huge gap between the students that we studied. It also suggests that we might question the notion that students should always go for prestige. You may have been advised, when you were looking at colleges, that you simply pick the most prestigious school that you get into. That may not be true. It may be that you pick the most prestigious school you can get into that also has organizational arrangements that are going to help you get where you need to go. Right? School, you know, a lot of students in the study pick the best school in the state and their family put everything in that basket, right? Because they thought that's what they should do. But in fact, it will turn on them, right? So also thinking about how the organizational arrangements might fit.